get, there's like four of them. Come one, come all. Where? Came from over here somewhere. Here we are. Anything back here? I don't think so. Lover speak. What in the hell? It's blocked off.
Agent Nightingale didn't want to be in Nightingale. These little communities revolted him, and he didn't like the trees or the coffee. He now knew that impossible horrors lurked behind the storefronts and smiles. He desperately wanted to turn the car around and just drive until he passed out or ran out of road and booze. But he had a job to do. He had a rider to catch, at any cost.
All right, across we go. Tina up there.
Shit.
Oh shit. My God, Alan.
Flashlights, kid stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
Old R1 is a flare.
Hell, of course I see him. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the gun. The story goes.
Yeah, but
let's move.
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice. He knew my name. We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, Wake! You better keep up! It's them!
Thank you. Dude, you better fucking use that gun. Fuck me. Dude, I really wish you used the gun. Oh my god. Use your gun, you idiot! Why do you got such a shit aim? He's right in front of you.
From the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun.
No time for back talk.
Oh my god.
A little longer. Scare them off. Just a little longer, I almost got it. Okay, it's open. Move it or lose
it. Let's go.
Oh, you feeling better now, Wake? All cozy and safe. Better get ready. They'll be on us soon. This is it, Wake. Last stand. There's more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
There you go. Oh, fuck me.
Stop fighting me!
Shoot him, please. Oh, shit. Oh, you missed me shots, bro. Oh, no. Shoot the guy that's weak in front of you, you idiot. Come on, I dodged that. Shoot, you idiot. Thank God.
Let's cut the act now.
Where's my wife?
I knew you were gonna say that. I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna write about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript, or she's gonna suffer bad.
You touch her off.
Oh. Why do you want the manuscript? He got Alice, bro. He tells me he doesn't have Alice. Oh.
And he wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power. But I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get back to Barry and figure out my next move.
Finders keepers. Oh, nice. Alright, keep going forward here. Oh, we didn't pick up the manuscript, did we? No, we did not.
On more than one occasion, Alice had tried to explain to me how it felt to be afraid of the dark. To her, darkness wasn't simply the absence of light, but something more tangible than that. It was something you could touch and feel. Worse than that, it was something with a mind of its own, something malicious and malign. For her, things changed when they were wrapped in darkness. They turned into something else, something foreign, and nothing was safe or innocent anymore. I'd never really understood what she meant until now.
Ooh, don't let the sound of that. I don't think it's gonna take me anywhere, but come on. No, use invisible wall. Oh, fuck. I forgot that was a thing in this game. At least we can see him. I saw the glowing white. I'm like, ooh, a manuscript. Nope. You're a trap. How I missed that. Kind of sad that I missed that. They're just camping in bushes. up this way? Some sort of building over here. Oh, fuck. Oh, thank God.
The night had been one desperate situation after another. I was exhausted, and my body felt as though it had been chewed up and spat out. The flashlight was heavy in my hand, and each pull of the trigger sent a painful shock up my arm. But I was finally out of the woods, and things were looking up. That's when I heard the chainsaw.
Uh-oh. Ooh, hunting rifle.
I had heard the plane fall. It made no sense. It was clear that it had just fallen here, but it was very old and obviously hadn't flown in decades. Looking at it sent a shiver down my spine.
Oh, some of this black stuff is on it. Supply over here somewhere. Oh, fuck.
What was that?
What's the supply at? I don't see any more arrows. I have no idea where this supply is. Oh, come on, I'm trying to get off of it. Oh. Thank God he missed. Oh my God, I missed. I'm missing one.
The logging site was a mess. The modular office had been pushed off the cliff. Deputy Thornton climbed up from the wreckage excited, breathing hard from the exertion. Nobody there. It's weird. Don't you think that's weird? Bored, Mulligan let out a mighty snort. Hell, it's always weird, Thornton. Just a question of sorting out what kind of weird it is this time around.
Oh, I missed a few, actually.
When Barry saw the darkness attack the visitor center, it made him a believer. The men Al said he'd shot, they hadn't been just locals on crank. Somehow the world had changed, like the channel had been switched without warning. You think you're watching a sitcom, and you're really watching a horror show. When the birds started attacking the cabin, Barry wasn't surprised, just terrified.
Ladder goes up. And this whole place is falling apart. Darkness wears her face. I climb over?
Shadows stirred and the wind picked up as I ran through the forest. I felt the dark presence turning its gaze toward me. Then the moonlight was blotted out by dark shadows that raced violently across the ground, moving too swiftly to be natural. Darkness gathered between the trees and melted again to reveal the Taken. No natural path had brought them here.
All right. Fucking neck is itchy, man. It's the wrong time for be itchy. Chainsaw. Well, he wasn't too hard. Big old boy, though.
Stay out of sight. I'm on my way. Don't open the door.
What, am I crazy?
Stay hidden. I'll be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on.
Oh, it's...
I still had to reach Barry at the cabin, but at least I was out of the woods.
Trailer parks here.
The FBI agent's command froze me in place. I considered surrender. It was all falling apart anyway. I could give in, let someone else deal with it. But it felt all wrong. Call it instinct, his posture, the way he held the gun. He was no friend. Shots ringing in my ears, I leaped for the hole in the fence and stumbled into the darkness beyond.
God, it's so dark in here. Oh, Keith. Oh. Jesus.
A story is not a machine that does what you tell it.
No, wait, one of these. The vehicle, let's go. That's right, baby. This game, you can drive. Was a boost? Oh, it takes up battery. Oh, here's a lodge. Where are we going with the truck? Goddamn taken.
It was the kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, Wake. You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
Not done?
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. Not, well, get me?
Yes, yes, I get you.
Oh my god, that's a lot of birds.
Barry had talked about birds over the phone.
Normal. These birds are weird.
Come on, birdies. God damn her birds, bro.
Barry, you can open the door now. They're gone.
Hey, Al. I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
It's all good, bro.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back. For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon. Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good.
Oh, no. That's not good.